Welcome back. In the last lecture, we have developed the procedure to design the PID controller using frequency domain specifications. In this lecture, we will consider one problem on design of PID controller. So let us directly move to it. In the given problem statement, for the given system, the system is a second order system, but it is a type 0 system. It doesn't have any pole at origin. And hence integral action is required to eliminate the steady state error for the step input. So hence we have to design for such systems always we have to design either PI or PID. So in this case it is asked to design a PI controller. And what is given for this system, we should get the phase margin of 50 degree at gain crossover frequency of 8 radian per second. Okay, so let us begin with. We have G of S is equal to 100 upon S plus 1 into S plus 10. So always whenever we are dealing with the frequency domain methods, we need to transform these to frequency response function. So G of J omega is 100 upon J omega plus 1 into J omega plus 10, and that is what I get. G of J omega at omega GC will be equal to 100 upon, here J omega, omega will be omega GC, and omega GC is given as 8. So this will be J 8 plus 1 into J 8 plus 10. And this gives me its magnitude as 100 divided by this imaginary part square plus real part square. So 64 plus 1 is 65, and here 64 plus 100 is 164, and it is coming 0.9685, and then its angle. So its angle at omega GC is equal to, for this it will be 0, so minus tan inverse of imaginary by real, that is minus tan inverse of 8, minus tan inverse of 8 by 10 is 0.8, and it is coming minus 121.53 degree, and this is nothing but phi for our notation. Now what is else given is phase margin is 50 degree, and at omega equal to omega GC, we have phase margin is equal to 180 degree plus phi plus theta, where phi is the angle of J of the system function at omega equal to omega GC, and theta is the angle contributed by the PI controller. So here theta will be equal to, phase margin is 50, so 50 degree minus 180 degree plus 121.53 degree, and which is coming minus 8.47 degree. So, and always see, PI controller is not used to improvement in the phase response. It is always used for the improvement in the steady state response. Transient performance is never improved. That is why in most of the cases you will get theta negative. That means negative theta means phase is negative, phase is added by the controller, correct? But still steady state performance will be achieved. And then, because if you see for this system, the system phase is minus 121, means already its phase margin is 58.47 degree. Already it is better, and we are reducing it. Phase margin is reducing means we are reducing the stability. But what is the purpose of using this PI controller? Purpose is that improve the steady state performance, remove the steady state error at step input. So such theoretical relevances with the practical shall be known. Otherwise, somebody may say that already we are getting 58. Why to reduce to 50? We shall improve the phase margin. But this improvement in phase margin is required. Then we will go for the derivative action. Or even in case of compensators, lead compensator is used to improvement in the transient performance. And to improve in the steady state performance, we will go by the lag compensator, which is almost equivalent to this PI controller. So let us move with this problem. So theta is also obtained, and now we will use the formula directly. So we have the formula Kp is equal to cos theta upon magnitude of the system at omega equal to omega gc. So cos theta is nothing but cos of minus 8.47 degree divided by this magnitude already we have obtained 9685 and it is coming 1.0213 kp. And then what we have for calculating ki, we need to equate kd equal to 0 in the formula of kd. So formula for kd is it's sin theta divided by magnitude of system at omega gc into omega gc plus ki by omega gc square. And hence 0 is equal to sin of minus 8.47 degree divided by this value is 0.9685, omega gc is 8 plus ki by omega gc square is 64. So upon solving this, we get ki is equal to 1.2167. And hence, the design is complete. But just let us write down its transfer function. So transfer function is gc of s is equal to kp plus ki by s, that is 1.0213 plus 1.2167 divided by s. It is in the kp ki form. Just take this common, you will get kc and ti. So we have solved this. Also we have seen some physical relevances of this with the practical aspects. It is enough in this lecture. In the next lecture, we will solve a numerical example on PD controller. Thank you.